Hello glowers, I'm so excited to announce the release of a never seen before 18 different colors of glow in the dark pigment and acrylic paint. First, let's understand why glowing pigments work and what actually makes them glow. Think of it like a flashlight with a battery, except this one charges and discharges naturally. It absorbs energy from any light source, daylight, artificial light, or even a laser beam, and stores it for later use. The most effective way is to charge it with the UV flashlight, also known as the black light, so it takes just a second to reach maximum glow. The first 5 minutes are the brightest. After that, the glow dims gradually but remains visible for up to 8 hours, depending on the color, charge time, and the light intensity. Glowing pigments and paints can be used in almost any way you can imagine. From transforming ordinary canvas paints into glowing masterpieces for your home decor, to customizing your sneakers with the unique eye-catching glow. You might wonder, isn't it radioactive? Don't worry, these pigments are 100% non-toxic and completely safe to use thanks to groundbreaking Strotium Illuminate molecular technology. We capture and release light without any radioactive materials involved. Now, let's take a closer look at these products. Our pigments have the finest grain, ranging from 0 to only 30 microns, which makes them suitable for a wide variety of applications. Raw pigment particles give the strongest glow, but what about pre-made paints? While the color of both is exactly the same, our acrylic paint formula glows a bit less. That's because we add a few extras, like inks to boost color intensity and other additives for the best overall experience. If you want to get the maximum glow, you can mix your own paints. For that, you will need your preferred paint base. I will be using transparent acrylic medium. You will also need an empty container for mixing, glow pigment of course, I am using Ocean Blue Sky Glow for this one, something to mix with, it can be a simple stick but I prefer spatulas, a few brushes and a surface like paper to test your mix, and some safety protection as well. Let's start mixing by adding the base into the container first, which will make the mixing process easier later. Right after, we can already add the glow pigment. Be very careful when taking the pigment out of the jar, it can be very dusty. I will start with a small amount at first, if needed, I will add more later. My goal is to reach maximum glow, the same as dry pigment. Make sure to mix it very well with the base, it takes time. For a smooth blend without any leftover unmixed grainy pigment balls, it takes a couple of minutes to mix. Looks like the two components are already blended, so now let's take a brush and paper sheet for a test. You can already see the blue color is very light, much lighter than the dry pigment, so it might not glow as bright. To be sure, let's light it up with the UV flashlight. And yes, it's barely visible for now, so let's mix more pigment into this paint. Now I will add a lot more. The recommended ratio is 30% pigment and 70% base, but it's just a rough guideline, so don't be afraid to experiment. The mixing process got a little bit messier, don't rush it or it will spill out like is happening to me now. Also take your time while mixing. Okay, so after a couple of minutes of mixing, it looks fine and smooth. Now we can test it again next to the first mixture for a comparison. You can already see that the new paint has a much richer color, and it looks like the same as dry pigment. So let's light it up again with UV. The brightness difference is huge now, and I think I reached maximum glow for my unique self-made paints. Now let's create something interesting with these glow paints. In my case, I will be customizing my old Vans tote bag. My purpose is to make this V-letter stand out and glow in the night. I will use already pre-mixed ocean blue paints. It will glow in the dark blue also, and let's see how it goes. I want to make sure my surface is smooth for easy paint application. When opening the paints, be careful taking off the lid. Paint can be on the back of it, so make sure you don't smear anything you didn't plan to. I am using my smallest size acrylic paint brush and starting to paint the edges with extra care. What I really don't want to do is accidentally paint over the black surface. If that happens, it won't wash off because of the premium pure ink used in these pre-made paints. The paints are already prepared for use right after opening, so you can use them straight from the jar like I am right now. I prepped a few different brush sizes for this customization process, but it's going very well with the smallest one, so I'm going to paint the whole thing using just this brush. So the first layer is already completed. Now just wait a little bit till the first layer will dry off completely, and then we will apply the second one. Don't forget to close your paints because it can dry off too. And also wash your brush. Applying the second layer, it seems like the red color already covers perfectly. So in my case, just two layers will be enough for the final result. Of course, you can add more layers if you want a smoother surface or stronger glow. After waiting half an hour, the paint has completely dried. And now it's time for the final reveal of Glow in the Dark customized tote bag. I hope you enjoyed this introduction video of the glowing world of pigments and paints. Thank you for watching, and now let's make the night glowing colors.